Ubuntu is a commonly used Linux operating system. However, most computers come with Windows. So rather than reinstalling the operating system or dual booting the computer, let's take a look at using VMware to create an Ubuntu 20 virtual machine on a Windows computer. So the first thing to do is open a browser and head to the VMware Player download page. In the lower left, you will click the Try Workstation Player for Windows tab. This begins downloading the VMware executable. Before we can use our virtual machine, we have to download our Ubuntu operating system. So let's head over to their download page. I will go ahead and install version 20.04. You'll notice that the Ubuntu ISO file is relatively large. If you have a slow internet connection, especially if you're on Wi-Fi, it may be worth going to the alternative downloads page and getting a torrent link to download Ubuntu in a torrent downloader, such as uTorrent, instead. This will help make sure you don't end up with a corrupted file. For the time being, I'm going to cancel this download since I already downloaded it ahead of time. Feel free to pause the video and come back when your download is finished. Alright, now let's go ahead and run the VMware installer. The wizard appears. Go ahead and click Next, which will bring up the user agreement. Go ahead and read through it, check the accept box, and hit next. Here you can change the install path, which I just leave as is, and check the enhanced keyboard driver, which allows for use of full feature and multi-language keyboards. Now I do not care for VMware checking for updates on startup, nor being part of the customer experience program, so I'll go ahead and uncheck those and hit next. I do want shortcuts placed on my desktop and start menu, so I will leave those ticked. And now, we go ahead and hit install. After about a minute or so, we can hit finish. Now it will prompt us to restart our computer. So I will go ahead and do that now, manually, so I can stop the recording, and I'll see you in a bit. Alright, I've restarted my computer, and hopefully you have done the same. So now let's begin configuring our Ubuntu virtual machine. Go ahead and open VMware. When it opens, go ahead and click Create New Virtual Machine. It is going to prompt us for the disk image of our operating system. So let's browse into our downloads folder and get our disk image. Select it and hit Next. Now VMware optimizes installation of certain operating systems. So we can put in our information here and it will automatically get put in to save us a little time when setting up the VM. You can give your Ubuntu user account whatever name and password you want. I'm just going to use my name and put in an easy to remember password. Now we are going to give our virtual machine a name. This will be the name we see in our list when we open VMware. I'm just going to note that this is a Ubuntu 20 machine and leave the default location. Now we are going to specify how much space on our hard drive we want this operating system to have. So I'll just leave it as such. Feel free to increase it if you think you will use this virtual machine more in the future. Now we get our final check prompt. I am going to go ahead and hit finish, which will start up our virtual machine. If you get prompted to download VMware tools for Linux, go ahead and do so. This will help enhance performance and give other extra features. As you can see, the Ubuntu installation will continue. This will take a while, especially if you have a lower end computer. For me, it took about 20 minutes or so. So I'm just going to speed up this video so you can see what happened along the way. But feel free to pause this video and come back when the install finishes. Alright, so our installation has finished. So let's go ahead and click on our user and log on. We can go ahead and maximize this window so you can use our entire screen. This is the Ubuntu Getting Started window. We will not set up live patch, and we will opt out of sending info to Ubuntu. I'll leave location services off, and we can go ahead and hit done. Congratulations! You now have a new virtual operating system. Feel free to customize the sidebar with apps you will use by right-clicking on them. I'll go ahead and remove these ones, since I'm not going to be using them. Then I will go ahead and click on the All Apps icon in the lower left and search for Terminal. I'll go ahead and click it. You can also use the key binding Ctrl-Alt-T to open a new terminal if you'd rather do it that way. Now that it is open, I can go to the sidebar, right-click, and favorite it, so it is there for me to use later in the future. When you want to shut down your virtual environment, you can click the power icon in the top right and click power off. Alternatively, you can use the terminal by typing shut down now and hitting enter. Great! You successfully configured your Ubuntu virtual environment. Hope you liked the video. Be sure to like, subscribe, and check out my online Udemy courses. Link in the description below.